Hello, Transfiguration School community. I'm here at school. You might hear a little bit of background noise. We still have a few teachers here. We still have our maintenance crew cleaning up and making sure that everything is ready whenever we open back our doors again. Today's a very, very special day. It's the solemnity of the Annunciation, which we commemorate every single time we pray the Hail Mary. And I'd like today, on this Wednesday, a day which we would normally gather together for Mass anyways, to read a portion of the Gospel and then to reflect very briefly with you about what this passage might mean for us all in these days. This passage comes from the Gospel of Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Boys and girls, brothers and sisters, Mary, when she first encounters the angel Gabriel, is uncertain as to what is happening. The angel comes to her and proclaims the good news of salvation, and Mary doesn't quite know what's happening. What's going on? How does this affect me? Why are you here talking to me? Mary is a little bit anxious. She trusts in God, but she's unaware of what is happening, what is being proclaimed to her. And I think all of us in this current time find ourselves in sort of similar situations, in the sense that things are kind of uncertain. Our parents are home. We're trying to figure out what this looks like working, but also providing our kids with a setting within which they can learn. We know that there are many people within our community who are really struggling, trying to figure out what tomorrow will hold, and just hoping that they, you know, are able to support their families. I know our students are really, really sad they're not here in school, right? You're really, really sad and wondering when it will end, when I can come back to school and be with my friends again. In all of this time of uncertitude, boys and girls, brothers and sisters, we are called to hear the words of the angel Gabriel. Do not be afraid. The Lord is in control. We need to trust him. It's not easy sometimes to trust what Jesus is doing. Not easy to say, "Lord, your will be done, not my will be done." But it's so important when we don't feel like we have control, when we don't know what tomorrow will bring, to cry out, "Lord, help me not to be afraid. Help me to be like Mary when she heard the words of Gabriel, and to trust in God's plan." May this solemnity of the Annunciation, a beautiful solemnity in which we are told that Jesus Christ is coming, may we ourselves trust in God, trust in his plan, and seek to love one another with a special strength during these days. And through the intercession of our Blessed Mother and the angel Gabriel, may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.